Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again to the second term of this e-learning session. Today, we are going to start our new term with a new topic of grammar, lesson number 14, simple present tense. Simple present tense is used to tell general truth. For example, the sun rises in the east. The stars twinkle in the sky. Simple present tense is used to tell actions which are done often, sometimes, or every day. For example, I pray to God every day. Rahul goes to school daily. Now, we will learn more about simple present tense. First of all, we will see the rule which we follow in simple present tense. Subject plus first form of the verb plus S or ES plus object. Now we will see way we use S or ES with first form of the verb. He, she, it and singular noun. Singular noun means one name. When our subject is he, she, it and singular noun, in that condition we use S or ES with first form of the verb. Now we will learn way we don't use S or ES. They, we, you, I and plural noun. Plural noun means more than one person, more than one name. Then in that condition, we only write first form of the verb. We don't write S or ES. Now, I will explain to you with some given examples. Our first example is, he plays with me. You can see, our subject is he. With he, I have told you earlier that we use first form of the verb plus ES. Our first form of the verb is play and we have added S to it because our subject is he. He plays with me. Now we'll see the second sentence. Ram goes to market. Ram is our singular noun because this is the name of one person. And with this we have used first form of the verb plus ES. Go is the first form of the verb and we have added ES to it. The sentence is Ram goes to market. Yes, see the third example. I read a story daily. In this sentence, our subject is I. And with I, we know that we don't use S or ES with first form of the verb. And our verb is read. I read a story daily. Our fourth example is Tina and Meena sit together. In this sentence, you can see there are name of two person. So this is plural noun because name of two persons are there. Tina and Meena sit together. In this sentence also, you can see that we have not used S or ES with first form of the verb. Yes, bacho, now we will learn to change the sentence of simple present tense into negative sentence. See the rule first. Subject plus do or does plus not plus first form of the verb plus object. To change the sentence of simple present tense into negative sentence, we use do or does. Now, I will explain to you where we use does and where we use do. He, she, it and singular noun. When our subject is starting with he, she, it and singular noun, in that case, we use does. And when our subject is starting with they, we, you, I and plural noun, in that case, we use do. I will explain to you with these given examples. See the first example. I have taken the same example to make it more clear. First example, he plays with me. We will change this sentence into negative. He, as I told you, that we will use does with he. He does not play with me. See the second example. Ram goes to market. Ram is a singular noun, and with singular noun we use does to change into negative. Ram does not go to market. Third example, I read a story daily. In this sentence, our subject is I. So, we will not use does, we will use do. I do not read a story daily. A fourth example is, Meena and Tina sit together. In this sentence, our subject is plural noun because there are name of two person. Meena and Tina sit together. To change this sentence into negative sentence, we will use do. Meena and Tina do not sit together. Now, we will learn to change the sentence of simple present tense into interrogative sentence. Yes, see the rule first. Do or does plus subject plus first form of the verb plus object plus question mark. Students, don't forget to put question mark in an interrogative sentence. Yes, to change the sentence of simple present tense into interrogative sentence, we will start our sentence with do or does. Yes, now see the examples. First example, he plays with me. To change this sentence into interrogative sentence, we will start the sentence with does. Does he play with me? Question mark. Don't forget to put this question mark. Second sentence, Ram goes to market. We will start our sentence with does. Does Ram go to market? Question mark. Yes, third sentence, I read a story daily. Our subject is I, so we will use do. We will start a sentence with do. Do I read a story daily? Question mark. Fourth example, Meena and Tina sit together. You can see, yes, this is a plural noun. There are name of two persons. So, we will use do to change it into interrogative sentence. Do Meena and Tina sit together? Question mark. Students, hope you all have understood. We have given you some sentences. Change those sentences into negative and interrogative sentences. Thank you.